that you're all here. Now, we want you to know that this isn't a quiet, sit in your seat, tap your feet kind of church. Whatever it is that you want to do to serve and praise your God on this day, then you can do it here at CCWDC. Now, if you want to flip a pew, flip a pew. If you want to run around the building, run around the building, because we are free to praise our God on this Pentecost service Sunday. Okay? Okay? That's a good place to praise them. Hallelujah.
How many of you are glad to be alive? Come on, let's stand for our feet. How many of you, the Lord has done something great for this week? Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. This is the time when we come together to worship. Yes, come on, we have come into this house. Let's sing that.
Break every chain. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. That's a good place to bless him right there. Go ahead and go into your secret place. Go ahead and go into, if you need to close your eyes, go ahead. Just you and God right there, right there, right there. Right there, go into the secret closet. If you need to talk in unknown tongues, right there, right there, right there. Make it personal. Right there. That's you and Daddy. Nobody else. Your neighbor ain't there. It's me, it's me, it's me, oh Lord. Standing in the need of prayer. Not my mama, not my dad. Right now, it's me, oh God. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for removing the weight so that I can breathe. Thank you, Lord, for lifting the pain so that I can breathe. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody join me, just say hallelujah.
Jesus' name we pray. We bless.
bless your name, oh God, for your goodness, for your kindness, for your awesomeness. Oh, we bless your name, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, and we give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. If you can, be seated. If you can, if you can, if you can, if you can. I understand if you can't. But if you can, somebody say if you can. Somebody say, here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my.
Welcome and greet all of our visitors. If you are visiting for the first, second, or third time, why don't you stand to your feet so that we can love on you a little bit. This is your first, second, or third time. Come on and stand. 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 Come on, let's make them feel better. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Come on, come on, come on. The ushers trying to place the visitor's card in your hand. Please accept that visitor's card with a smile on your face. You know, we're a good, happy place. Put a, there you go, smile on your face. We just want to basically capture your information so that we can make sure we stay in contact with you. I'm going to ask that at the time, if you have a church home, please take back my greetings to your pastor. Everybody got a church home, take back your greetings to your pastor. And secondly, if you don't have a church home, if you're looking, if you're searching, amen, I would love to offer you the hand, a right hand of fellowship, and ask that you come on during the time of invitation to join this branch of Zion. This is a good place. This is good ground. Is that the right church? We don't take it for granted. We thank God for your presence. Now, I'm going to ask that everybody else that's in the sanctuary stand to your feet and help me greet our visitors first, and then greet each other by saying, Jesus loves you, and so do I.
Yeah.
Your tenses in the English language. Sometimes we talk about God in the past tense. Most often we talk about God and what God is going to do in the future tense. But when you get to talking about right now, there's something about right now. In the very breath that you're breathing, the root right now. I don't know what tomorrow holds. I remember what last night held, but right now, God's goodness is sufficient. Grace is sufficient. Mercy is sufficient. And so we say thank you.
Thank you,
Lord. For those who are visiting with us, do you feel welcome? We got glowing all over here. For those who are visiting with us for the first, second, or third time, do you feel welcome? Holler out with a loud, resounding yes or no.
Yes.
We get no no's. Bless the Lord. We thank God. We believe in being a hospitable place. Y'all know God destroyed cities because they were inhospitable. The name of those cities were Sodom and Gomorrah. He destroyed them, wiped them out, because they were some mean, nasty folks. And we don't believe in being mean or nasty. We believe in showing forth the love of God in all of our interactions. Now somebody said, keep it holy, the love of God. Y'all will get that in the morning. Amen. For those who are viewing the service live via YouTube or Ustream, we also welcome you into the worship service. Somebody, let's give God a hand clap of praise for those who are viewing the service live. In 2013, community, what are we going to do? We're going to walk in the promise. That's our theme for this year. But more importantly, more than just a theme, we're saying that we're going to walk into everything God has in store for us. There's some promises with your name written all on it. There's some promises that God has promised you before you even were born in your mother's womb. And it's time to begin to obtain the promises. So long we have been stuck on stupid. So long we have done some of the same things and not got it right. But this year we're professing that we're going to do better. We're going to walk in a posture where we're saying, Lord, we're ready to receive all that you have for us. That means living right. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
That means giving right. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
That means serving right.
Yes.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. All right. Happy Pentecost Sunday to everybody.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Mr. Faison. Happy Pentecost Sunday to everybody.
Thank you.
I love you on this day. I love you always. Pentecost Sunday is 50 days from the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Penta 5. Pentecost. This is the day that we remember, that we reflect on the gift of the Holy Spirit coming to the church. And as Reverend Lamar said earlier, this gift came and it brought power. Not just power to dance and speak in tongues, but power to get out and show forth that God is real, that Jesus Christ, love is for everybody. And so I want to remind you and encourage you on this day, Pentecost Sunday, that you think about how the Holy Ghost is calling you to be a bold and faithful witness during these last evil days. Amen.
Amen.
Couple of announcements for you. Take out the calendars. Make sure you jot it down. If you need to be baptized and you haven't been baptized and you're seeking baptism, if that's you, you can just wave your hand real quick. The deacons are going to look around just to get a scan. Wave your hand. If you need to be baptized, look around, deacons. Look around. If you need to be baptized, you joined the church and you joined as a new member, you joined as a person giving your life to Christ, and you haven't been baptized before, just wave in the atmosphere. Wave into the atmosphere. Amen. Amen. There are some that are not in this room. Let's make sure we capture their name. On June 1st, at 2 p.m., we will be holding baptism. It'll be happening at Covenant Baptist United Church of Christ. And you can see Deacon Simmons for more information about baptism. He's waving his hand at the front. Secondly, for those who made it to the pastor's study, it's an interactive study that I produced from the pastor's study on last offering. Who made it there? Wave your hand. Wave your hand, man. Okay. Amen, amen. Now, we have another one coming up. That one was for the singles. It was geared to the singles, and the title was
It's mating and baiting season. This one that's coming up are for couples. If you are in a relationship, if you got on your Facebook status, it's complicated. If you, wherever you are, we're gonna meet you right where you are. You can come to this next study on this Thursday, May 23rd at 7 p.m. It's geared to couples. Geared to couples. Somebody say geared to couples. The title of this discussion, First Jean, my spouse, we're producing this, is called, It's Getting Hot in Here. Don't go taking off all your clothes.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
We're having some candid, real discussion with couples on how to keep your relationship, how to make sure you keep a happy home, how do you make sure you do the compromising and communication that's needed in order to be effective in your relationship. Somebody know that being single is difficult, right? But I can attest that being a couple is even harder. Come on.
See, sometimes don't y'all know being human, your mind will forget exactly what's next.
And he said, it's the vision statement, Pastor, the vision statement. So I said, come on up and do it. That's the Lord saying you need to do it. Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord, church. Let me pound your program. I'm going to read it with everyone. Amen. God bless your heart in the ministry. Together, our mission is to be an expression of God's love in the world. We are an inclusive and diverse church, a place of unconditional love that inspires all individuals in our community. Partnering with the Holy Spirit and the community, we are committed to fighting and eradicating social ills that oppress God's children, preventing them from experiencing a fulfilled life. God bless you.
Bless the Lord. Thank you so much, Keith, for being always ready. Somebody give Keith a hand for being always ready. We thank God. It's offering time, church.
Amen.
Once again, it's offering time, church. See, it's important to get excited about every aspect of worship. Too often, offering gets downplayed. Too often, offering gets swept under the rug because we feel like we talk about folks' money, but we don't want to talk about that. Well, I just want to quickly remind you as you prepare your giving that it's important that you give honor where honor is due. God has given us so much. God has blessed us so graciously, given to us so freely, and it's important that we take a portion back and say, Lord, here you are. Thank you for doing all that you've done for me. It's important that you honor God in all that you do, including this moment, the offertory moment. The old folks used to put it this way, that when we don't take up our time, when we don't take up our talents, when we don't take up our treasures and give them back to the Lord, we're cursing ourselves with a curse. Somebody wonder why you had so much, but now you're trying to figure out how to make two dimes equal a dollar. Maybe, just maybe, you're cursing yourself by not giving unto the Lord's kingdom what the Lord is calling of you. I'm going to encourage you in this hour to think about this as your time of worship. Giving back to God so that everybody in this community, everybody in this house that's in need will be able to have. Somebody say amen for that.
Amen.
Let's get excited about bringing our gifts to the storehouse. Be excited about giving back to God just a little bit of what God has given to us. And let's give from an honest place. We thank God for everything. Stand to your feet all over this place and let us prepare for the offertory moment. God, we thank you for this time. We thank you for this opportunity to worship you in giving. There's so many folks that don't have, but you gave us something, oh God. When we look at those in DR and we look at those in third world countries, they have very little to nothing. God, we take this moment to honor you, to say thank you, so that we can ensure that everybody that's connected to us, everybody that's close to us, we'll have, because we are a community that you place together. So, Lord, we say blessing. Use it so that it will build, so that it will encourage, so that it will help somebody get through their hard times. It's in Jesus' name we pray. And everybody that agreed, come on and join in and say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Follow the direction. Amen. Let us stand to our feet all over this place for the doxology. All things come of thee, O Lord.
I'm
going. Come on, help me out. The glory. To God be the glory.
Sometimes you gotta press your way into the presence of the living God. Sometimes you gotta press
And when you get there, you gotta wrestle. And tell the Lord, I'm not gonna let you go until you're blessed. I'm not gonna let you go until you turn it around. I'm not gonna let you go until you change my situation. I'm not gonna let you go. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. To the end of God. Oh, you are wonderful, worthy of all that is high. Excellent, worthy to be exalted, O God. Glory to the name, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory to your name, Lord God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Bless your name, Lord God. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
He's the Father, Spirit, and Son. The Lion and the Lamb. The Lion and the Lamb. How great is our God.
Thank you.
prayer as we minister to the Spirit of God. Lord, amen. Amen.
Lord.